Many magnificent spots in the globe can be found in the United States. For instance, there's the Grand Canyon, the Rocky Mountains, and even the magnificent ocean of the planet. It's no surprise that it's regarded as one of the most beautiful continents in the world. The United States founded its own National Park Service in 1916 with the aim to conserve these many magnificent areas. The Park Service currently manages 63 of the country's protected sites. This covers an area of 85 million square kilometers, approximately equal to the size of Germany. Yellowstone National Park is one of these well-known parks that the National Service Park is looking into. This park can be found in the northwestern region of Wyoming, with some overlap in Montana and Idaho, as it encompasses around 9,000 square kilometers of territory. Wildlife abounds in Yellowstone, as do various geothermal features. One of these is the Old Faithful, a cone geyser that erupts water 54 meters up in the air every 90 minutes or so. Every year, about almost 4 million people visit the park to enjoy the lovely sights it has to offer. Nobody, on the other hand, appears to be aware that Yellowstone is concealing a deadly secret. Are you aware that Yellowstone is situated right on top of the world's largest supervolcano? Yes, I'm referring to a volcano, not just large in the North American continent, but on the entire globe. Isn't that terrifying? In addition to that, did you know that the Yellowstone caldera that we have today was constructed by a series of massive volcanic eruptions that occurred a long time ago? One of these volcanic eruptions occurred 2.1 million years ago, while another occurred 1.3 million years ago. And the most recent occurred roughly 664,000 years ago, according to records. Super eruptions were the geological term for these eruptions. This means that they would always be categorized as magnitude 8 or greater in the Volcano Explosivity Index, which is insane to comprehend. These eruptions eject lots of molten material and lava that would harm everything on its path. The most recent eruption encircled Yellowstone Lake and ejected so much material that it produced a 55 by 80 kilometer depression on the land we now know as the current Yellowstone Caldera. Analyzing the history of the eruptions in Yellowstone, the volcanic eruptions appeared to have a disturbing pattern. Take this into consideration. Following the third most recent explosion, the second most recent explosion occurred around 800,000 years. The most recent one only occurred approximately 636,000 years after the second one. The most recent explosion occurred 664,000 years ago, and that is about 28,000 years longer than the duration between the two most recent explosions. This is also one of the main reasons why Yellowstone is frequently garnering attention. Because the volcano is now dormant, experts and scientists have repeatedly assured the public that an eruption in Yellowstone will not occur anytime today. This is based on over 30 years of research, and the information they gathered indicated that while a massive eruption is theoretically feasible, it is unlikely to occur within the next 10,000 years. But what if scientists' prediction didn't come true, and the volcano in Yellowstone erupted? How awful would it be? Let's make some guesses. Yellowstone's entire volcanic system is enormous. The magma chamber that now sits beneath the national park measures 60 kilometers long, 29 kilometers wide, and 8 kilometers deep, and houses an incredible volume of molten lava. Let's say that one day, a massive plume of molten rock goes up from hundreds of miles beneath the Earth's surface, feeding this chamber. And as the magma goes up and cools in the chamber, the ground in Yellowstone will rise and fall regularly. This would even result in the elevation of the ground in Yellowstone Park moving up by a few inches per year. It's important to note that any major eruption would almost certainly be accompanied by a lot of seismic activity, which would serve as a warning indication that something catastrophic was about to happen. That is why, according to many seismologists, there might be significant earthquakes occurring weeks or even months before an eruption in Yellowstone, as magma breaks up the rock beneath as it rises to the surface. This is also due to the pressure that would keep developing and growing in strength until there was nowhere else to go but up. The magma would erupt through the ground, sending debris as high as 24 kilometers into the atmosphere. Right after the explosion, the lava would envelope the surrounding area, which is basically the entire territory of the national park itself, putting everyone within 65 kilometers of the epicenter at risk of being physically buried in lava. Aside from the immediate threat of burning, the explosion would eject a million cubic kilometers of material into the sky. This would lead to the forming of an umbrella cloud that would spread uniformly in all directions, making skies look dark throughout much of the North American continent. Unfortunately, this cloud will pour down deadly volcanic ash throughout the whole mainland United States. The places that would be most hit by this, with up to a meter of thick hot volcanic ash, are Wyoming, Idaho, Colorado, Montana, and Utah. On the other hand, Denver, Boise, and Salt Lake City will suffer significant damage as well, if not total destruction. There would be inches of ash covering everything in places throughout the Midwest, Nevada, and northern Alberta. The Atlantic and Pacific coasts would almost certainly see a light coating, but this would be dependent on the time of year and weather patterns involved during the explosion. The saddest part of it all, of course, would be the terrible, devastating impact on human life. Even if people are not near the epicenter, a 4-meter layer of ash being thrown down on a metropolis would kill not only humans, but also vegetation and animals. This event could completely wipe off the Midwest's corn and soybean crops, as well as poison farmland for the next generation. If this happens, food production in the United States would be significantly hampered, and in order to survive, America would most likely have to rely on food imports from other continents. In fact, a few inches of ash can already destroy farms, impede roads, and cause major health problems for almost the entire population. The explosion would also destroy essential infrastructure, poison water supplies, shut down power lines, affect all air travel throughout the continent, and even destroy electrical transformers, thus shutting down America's electricity system, adding to the sheer catastrophe that is about to engulf North America. If ever Yellowstone explodes, a massive volcanic eruption would have a significant impact on the global climate. A change in the global climate would certainly affect everyone who lives on this planet in some way. It's worth noting that volcanoes can release sulfur aerosols that reflect sunlight away from the Earth, causing the temperature to decrease, thus inducing cold weather. To put it another way, when Mount Pinatubo erupted in the Philippines in 1991, it is said that it cooled the planet by 1 degree for at least a few years. The same thing happened in Indonesia in 1815 with the massive Tambora eruption, which was believed to have chilled the planet so much that it damaged crops around the world, potentially causing severe famines in some areas. Snowfall was even recorded in June that year in the eastern portion of the United States, making it known as the year without a summer. The eruptions of these two volcanoes, on the other hand, were little compared to the devastation that a supervolcanic Yellowstone eruption can cause. Although it's difficult to say for sure, experts believe that the volume of material released into the atmosphere after a major eruption in the Yellowstone would cause the planet to cool by up to 10 degrees for a decade. Of course, the drastic change in climate would result in a global disaster. It would make crops all over the world fall to damage, and in this case, it has the potential to put lives of hundreds of millions of people into starvation, and would also cause significant damage. If Yellowstone were to blow up anytime today, FEMA, the U.S. Federal Emergency Management Agency, projects that the damage would be $3 trillion. As you can see, if Yellowstone erupts, the consequences will be catastrophic for everyone. But don't worry, it's doubtful that it will happen in our lifetime. Based on the frequency of the three major eruptions, the chances of it happening in any given year are around 0.0001%, which is so much lower than the chances of humanity being destroyed due to an asteroid striking the Earth's surface. So, yeah, you don't need to be concerned about this right now. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Please click the bell icon so you'll be notified when new videos are posted. And as always, thanks for watching. Ponder this.